things, one of the lessons that was taught by the global depression of the 1930s is that when there is a financial market and banking market collapse, that is the time when governments have to intervene with large-scale fiscal stimulus packages.
The American Recovery and Reinvestment Act that I will sign today, a plan that meets the principles I laid out in January, is the most sweeping economic recovery package in our history.
A year ago today, we had only one computer lab in our school and no other technology. And now we have teachers using smart boards, document projectors, and really boosting ourselves up to where we can be a 21st century school. We've had a gap in some of our groups of students that have struggled, and now we have tutors working in the classroom side by side with students that need additional help. And I think we'll see the success this year from that.
The money was broken down. It ranged from saving 37 reading teacher positions. Otherwise, these teachers would have been let go. But it really, the primary thing that the money was used for is to really better educate our students and to really catch up in some areas where our state funding has really been lagging. Most of our local taxation is paying for the education of our students, and every year the state is sending us less and less. You know, we want to do a lot of things for our students, but unless they have the technology, the hardware, the laptops to use, then there's not much we can do. There's just so many areas where the money's just not there. We're thankful that the federal government provided the stimulus money, because it came in very handy and it was very useful to our students.
A majority of the funding is going to be used to construct the major interchange at I-10 and Loop 375 in East El Paso. This stimulus project will allow us to make four of those connections directly from one freeway to the other nonstop. For commuters, that means a lot, because right now they're going to have to negotiate either a traffic signal or parts of the frontage road and merging in and out of traffic to make that, which no longer be necessary with the direct connectors. This big project at I-10 and Loop 375, we're anticipating that at the peak there'll probably be 200 people working out there. Those projects would not have happened because of the economic crisis, but now with the stimulus program, we were able to put them back into the program or increase the size of some of those projects because of stimulus.
We use them in numerous projects. One is we started developing transfer centers. We actually used the money to help pay mostly one shelter or one transfer center was the Glory Road Transfer Center, and that was almost $9 million went to that. We also have the West Side Transfer Center, and that one I think we had around $2.5 million of that. So it helped those projects get along quicker without us incurring debt. As far as our employees go for the city of El Paso, those jobs, we were able to maintain our service levels, and that was important because most transit systems I think are decreasing service, and they're not maintaining the same service levels they did a year or two ago. We were just the opposite. We were able to not only maintain, but do a little increasing of those services. And when you tie that into not decreasing services, but giving better service out, then I think that's a win-win situation for El Paso all around.
One of the most exciting projects that we have going from Ara Money is an all-green community that's gonna be built right here in El Paso, Texas. This is actually probably the only all-green community in the entire state, and we were one of basically 36 lucky cities to have received this in the United States. What it's going to be is 64 units that are going to be completely green, which means it's going to have solar, it's going to probably have wind power, it's going to probably have reclaimed water, it's going to have low-flow toilets, it's going to have refrigerated air, it's going to be everything that this area of the country needs to try to stop using excess resources.
in terms of healthcare and medical education, such as what's taking place in and around the Texas Tech medical campus and in and around the Health Sciences Center here at UTEP. That allows those programs to ramp up towards full capacity much more quickly than would have otherwise been the case, because those investments in the facilities and in the machinery, equipment, and the software required to put them into place will now occur more quickly.
We purchased a confocal microscope. It is a microscope that allows us to do three-dimensional images of cells. And by having the instruments themselves, we can then perform proof-of-concept experiments or perform preliminary experiments that will allow us to obtain more funding. That's the whole idea of the Recovery Act money, that you build up the instruments or build up a university so they can compete or be more competitive for funding with in a pool of other universities.
We had a priority of stations that need to be built in the growing community of El Paso, and we were funded for Station 31, which will be located on the west side of the city of El Paso, serving an area that is currently underserved by the fire department. In fact, that area in total probably will receive about 3,000 calls or more a year that will be serviced by this fire station, and that is one of the areas of our city that we have some extended response times as well. It's going to give the community of El Paso a needed resource. It's going to, you know, provide the department and the city the ability to meet the demand that's already there. And I think ultimately this funding saves lives.
A million of it is for our capital improvement program, which is a new clinic at our Lisbon facility. And then we have an increased demand for service, which is to see additional patients, have additional staff. So we've established it. We haven't been able to acquire a new provider, because that's what it would entail. That's a big issue, is have access and trying to recruit providers so they are able to then, because sometimes you might have anywhere from 30 to 45 days to 60 day wait just for an appointment or a follow-up appointment. We've seen an increase of patients constantly, and it's turning more into the middle class that are losing their jobs and are coming in because they've lost their insurance. And what we currently have is a 2,000 square foot facility right now, so it's going to go up to about 6,500 square foot facility, which means it's going to have about from two exam rooms to probably nine exam rooms, where it allows me to have now, instead of one provider, I can have two providers there. The other ERA funds that we got were for our preparatory school, where they're doing adult education. And they hired AmeriCorps to do adult education, GED, ESL classes.
The stimulus projects that resulted as a consequence of the congressional budgetary actions, allowed El Paso to emerge, from a labor market perspective, in much better shape than it typically would observe during national downturns, and as a consequence of those investments in infrastructure, education, and other areas of the county and the region at large, it has allowed El Paso's jobless rate to remain lower than what is observed nationally.
But we acted because failure to do so would have led to catastrophe. We acted because we had a larger responsibility than simply winning the next election. We had a responsibility to do what was right for the U.S. economy and for the American people. And 1 year later, it is largely thanks to the Recovery Act that a second depression is no longer a possibility.